It's just good posture.
Morning. So it's a rain day this morning. I don't know how many inches of rain we got or what amount of precipitation, but it rained all day yesterday. Must be a dreary day today. So we are going to do some things to our corn head. We got our head sight row feelers in, so no more steering on corn. That's going to be nice to keep Dad happy. I'll probably never get to ride the combine anymore. And then we've also got our Devastator parts. We're going to try to install those. But first and foremost, we got to feed the livestock. In the last video, I said something about rat decon, and a lot of people were concerned about Squishy's health. These are not those grain bins, so there's not much decon out over here. And the places that we do have it are places that Squishy can't go. There's still rats here, but not near as many. Partially because it's a newer grain facility, and they just haven't had time to move in. And I'm sure he doesn't hurt the situation any. But most of those rats are bigger than Squishy. Anything to add?
Meow.
Got Ohio Ag here fixing BJ's mess up.
Say what now?
Oh, you didn't know you messed up?
You gotta at least warn me when I do this stuff. Oh.
Now, we had a slight issue with the gleaner, the rear spreader, the chaff spreaders weren't working. Not the ones out of the rotors, the smaller ones. Wasn't a huge deal. In corn and beans, we will need those to work, so we just kept rolling, and now that it's raining, they're down here seeing what's going on there. One of the benefits of the gleaner, very good warranty coverage, so warranty work. This is our auto steer stuff for our corn head. So our combine does have auto steer, but in corn, most people are not using the auto steer function. It's just not accurate enough. You're using row feelers. So there's actually two little things that are touching the corn. That's what's steering the combine. That's what we have in here.
Looks like a whole lot of wiring.
They gave us a bag of mints. I guess they're saying our breath stinks. So one thing we're gonna do while we're over here working today, since we're gonna be near the bins, we're gonna transfer dry corn out of our bin number 2 into our large bin. Like I said in the previous video, our drying system, unfortunately the air system is not big enough to reach that big bin. We just don't have a big enough blower on our dryer. So I'm going to go over here and me and BJ are going to get that transferring. That way we have plenty of space for dry corn when we get back into corn. So you may be wondering, why don't we just tie in or get a bigger blower for this, to reach this bin. Blowers are expensive, and to be honest, when we replace that blower, it'd be more likely to maybe put it in a drying leg and have it just dumping into a leg. But to do that, we'd have to get a different dryer. So for now, this system works for us. Doors are shut, corn's hitting the bin. Perfect.
BJ's tying down our AGI cables in this beam bin. Put some of these into the floor to tie the fishing string down.
So the tech's ready for us to test out the spreader on the back of the combine. So gonna back this thing out, see what we got. He changed some stuff around, put a new solenoid or something on what he said. Hopefully that fixes the problem. Oh look, our new pressure washer's here. So that was our big purchase from the Farm Science Review. Hot water pressure washer. So hopefully we're getting a run through on how to use that thing. And hopefully Dad and BJ are paying attention. All right, we need to go check out this new power washer. Maybe I can get my truck in line and they could just clean my truck while they're demonstrating. Because old girl's been parked under the maple tree too long, and I need my truck clean. A little bit dirty.
A little sappy.
And I got the guys checking the truck, so he's probably gonna want that. Are you mesmerized?
Beautiful. It sounds really hot. Peel the paint off. You hit rusty with that, you have to get another truck.
It's a 4,000 PSI 4-gallon event pump.
Just unbolt the body off here.
Yeah.
switch comes to the wand
so that we can change wands or change ends on the wand while the pressure washer is still running. Plus we got a soap dispenser that plugs into the whole thing so we can turn that wand into a foam cannon.
There's all kinds of things you can turn off.
So what did we find out was wrong with the spreader?
It was turned off in the menu.
So there's nothing wrong with the combo?
Nothing wrong.
User error.
Heaps.
Olivia, you want to clean my truck?
Yeah. That thing will knock you over. Grab a hold of that thing, I'll knock you over.
So we just got a text message stating that Cargill, local elevator, has half on drying. So we weren't going to harvest today. We were going to work on that head. We're going to go harvest now. We have one farm that's very close to Cargill. We are going to need space. We're just going to take it straight out of the field to Cargill. So that's the plan. They're doing that today and tomorrow. We might be able to do those acres in that time frame. So change of plans. And I currently have the cutest Uber driver to help us move around.
I expect tips.
I'll give you a tip.
Big tip.
I didn't even get a wash off my truck.
Oh well. Half drying's calling my name.
So BJ and I, we're going to move trucks around. Kale's going to give us a ride back here. Dad,
he had to go let his dogs out. Me and BJ think that's code for going and taking a dump. Let us know what you think, but every day after lunch, he has to go let the dogs out. I think he's going to take a crap.
I am always looking for this and I can never find it. That goes in my pickup. I believe it's been riding around in here for a year. But me and BJ put a new exhaust elbow on this truck.
So we're going to be taking the whole fleet of trucks up there where we're going to town. It could take a little while.
Now we had to clean this truck out.
She's getting dirty.
Maybe that pressure washer will clean this goop off the side of it too.
Come on. There we go.
Well, apparently everyone's got to poop. He had to get a ride to go to the potty. He just caught his wife and she just happened to be close by.
So in a previous video, we mentioned BJ's truck was still getting brake lines. Well, it's still getting brake lines.
So while I'm waiting on them, I'm just gonna go ahead and wash my truck real fast.
Okay, so turn this on. Well, crap. Waiting on a grain train. That grain train is holding up our grain train.
Apparently this is a self-driving Uber service.
Yeah.
Do I get a discounted rate?
Nope.
No.
Mommy, turn the monkey. I know
it. You ever heard of copyright infringement, kid?
Bye, thanks for the ride. So me and BJ left Dad over there. He's harvesting a bin load right now. BJ's in the grain cart, I'm in the last truck, and then we'll be moved over. We're leaving my pickup here. We'll have one pickup at the field. We'll get the other pickup after we get done tonight.
Combine's full.
So we're a whopping 5 acres in, and we might be getting a rain here soon. Might be a short harvest day. But hey, if we just do 5 acres a day and get rained out, it's more harvest videos for you guys.
My truck's in, ready?
Is that thing full?
Yeah.
Okay.
So we had an inch of rain yesterday, but this farm we're at right now is very gravelly. So we've ran this field before after 6 inches of rain and waited like a day and a half. So it takes a lot of rain to keep us out of this field as far as running up the field with tire tracks.
I mean, for an inch of rain, they're not even leaving any tracks.
I guess I should say, I don't know if this farm in particular had an inch, but the other farms had an inch of rain.
Apparently we ain't got much competition for line space today.
Trying to rain. Okay, so right here I'm putting my ticket info in the pipe ag system. That's going to be really nice, keeping track of all of our tickets like that, automatically going into spreadsheets this way. That'll be pretty handy.
Alright, trying to get a little corn harvested before it rains today. You see, it's already rained on this side of the cab. whatever here has been dry. Love doing this when it rains. I get a little cardio in because I have to get out and untarp a truck and then re-tarp a truck. Gets the heart rate up, gets the blood flow, and lets me know I'm alive. As opposed to just sitting in here on my rear end all day.
Still sprinkling. But it's not too bad. So in corn, you can harvest corn in the rain until it will not feed into the combine or until the fodder gets so damp that it plugs up your sieves. We've got a long ways to go with this stuff. I mean, it's a little damp, but if it doesn't do any more than this, we'll be able to keep running. If nothing else, we've knocked out 15 extra acres we won't have to do tomorrow. Looks like they're just about done with that field already. So like I said, it's a very droughty ground we're on. I mean, I was having an inch of rain yesterday and still being able to harvest on it without tearing it up, should tell you that. But Dad said the yields are still pretty good here, so that's good. They need to steal their auger or their conveyor. I think they'd notice.
Okay, I think Dad is done with the field they were in. He's starting another one. BJ's in town. He took a load before they closed. So Cargill is now closed. Because there's basically only us and a couple others driving in the town.
So they closed at 5. But we're going to load all the trucks, load the cart, see where we're at. We should, I mean really for a day that we didn't think we were going to even harvest, we're going to end up with about 50 acres, so not bad for an afternoon. He's full. So one thing I love about running these tractors on the grain cart, pedal mode. Right now we are in gear. We're not going to go anywhere until I push pressure on that pedal. Really handy for loading grain cart or loading trucks with a grain cart. You can just ease right up and you're still in gear. You can let off, just sits there. Very good. Much better than a power shift. Looks like we have a truck and a half to load, plus the cart. I thought this little truck down here at the end was empty. Turns out it's also loaded. So there's our pipe bag ticket reports. BJ's comparing to what the scales say. And while he's doing that, I'm running the cart. We're along this wood line, so we're dumping sitting still because we got stuff like that hanging out. I gotta say, I don't think there's 340 bushel corn right here. Here, folks, we can see the really dirty windows.
Who planted with this piece of crap?
You did last.
No.
Yeah, you did. You planted double crops.
Oh, that's right. We're on the wrong tractor. I'm going to have you know, both tractors have dirty windows from planting. But in my defense, I was told we're going to put this cart on a John Deere, which I spent a morning cleaning the cab out. And the next morning I show up, hey, go ahead and hook it to the Challenger. Let's go. Hurry, hurry, hurry.
But now we have our new hot water power washer.
It should be pretty good for cleaning windows, I think.
Yeah, buddy, we get some.
Big buck. He's like a spike. You see him?
Yes, I do, actually.
Give BJ his captain seat back. We're gonna hop in the combine with Dad here in a second. So one thing we're gonna do now, I mean, it's only 6 o'clock. There's only so many more acres we can run before we're full of trucks. So we're going to remove the spinner off of the back of the combine. That is what's coming out of the chopper in the combine. I'm gonna remove that, that way we know what kind of rotor loss we've got going on. Right now, it's coming out of that rotor, going into the chopper, and getting launched into oblivion. This way we'll be able to actually dig through there and see what kind of rotor loss we actually have. Looks like we got a couple bolts there we gotta take out, and that's it. Yep, looks a little different with no spinner back there. So I believe this is what you do if you want a windrow. But the fact of the matter is, I've never windrowed any straw through a gleaner, so I'm not 100% sure. I don't think we have a lot of rotor loss, but never hurts to double check. On the monitor, it is always showing just a little bit, but you can adjust that with sensitivity, so it's best to do this. You can actually see what's actually coming out of the rotor. With any combine, you can turn down your sensitivities on those sensors, and you can make them read whatever you want. Now there's what it looks like. No spinner back there. Now I have a chart to help us calculate what kind of rotor loss we are looking at, but it's on my phone. So we'll just have to take a, just count out how many we got in a square foot and then go from there. My phone's not here. So we just had 14 kernels in a square foot, but keep in mind, normally that would be spread out across the whole back of the machine. So that's not like when the spreader's on, finding 13 kernels in a square foot. That would be, really, you should probably take that and divide it by 30 feet because that, the head's 30 feet wide. I would assume, like I said, I've got a chart back there, so we'll have to look at that.
Two. Yeah.
So we was on the phone with an AGCO rep, and apparently when you condense that chopper down like that, it actually comes out to 60 kernels in a 12 by 18 square for one bushel. And we were at 20. We told him 20, and he told us a couple things. He thinks we can get it down to under 10. So that is just chopper loss or rotor loss, so keep that in mind. There is sieve loss and header loss to figure in as well. I don't think we're losing much on the head because this corn's not super, super dry. If this was 14 or 15% corn, we'd probably have at least a bushel of header loss, but that's not the case. So I'm gonna make some adjustments, and yeah, I think we can get this down even even further.
Spinner, it wasn't on. I'd hit it or something, turn it off or something. I did not know that. Yeah, I didn't either until we found it.
So right now we're just kind of playing with the monitor. We just got done with the live stream. All the trucks are full. If you missed it, check out that live stream. You can see the gleaner live in action. Even did some loss calculations. Good stuff. But right now we're playing around the monitor.
Trying to get those end rollers to work.
We don't know if we've got something turned off in the monitor. Hit turn that, click, hit that red check.
Well, it.
Oh, live stream must be over. Hey, bub.
What?
Did you think I was going to run you over with the grain cart earlier?
When?
You weren't moderately concerned?
Cab corn?
That corn back there is from cab corn.
Where?
First pass.
Yeah, back in that corner. There
that's when we were still
at
Cargill. Them geese are coming right to it.
Oh, same.
You tell it on yourself?
No, I didn't do it. Why would I have a power takeoff turned on in the middle of the field, huh?
Hmm.
It's not my fault until the PTO comes on.
Hey, looky there. My truck's like clean from 50 feet. Forgot to end the video. Thanks for watching, folks. And don't forget to thumbs up the video. Check out the links in the description, and we'll see you in the next one.